Hello students, in today's session I am going to discuss with you a very important topic, that is fibers and fabrics. Now while you are working in the housekeeping department, you will come across the various types of linens. Some linens are made up of pure cotton, some linens are made up of silk, etc. So you should have a clear idea about those various types of linens, how with which fibers they are made up of. Now, Unit 6, Fiber and Fabrics, I have divided the topic into two sections. In Section A, I will be just discussing with you the classification of these fibers, and Section B, their advantages and disadvantages. Now, classification of fibers. Fibers are broadly divided into two parts. Those are natural fibers and man-made or artificial fibers. Now, natural fibers, they are obtained from nature. Again, natural fibers, they have been classified into three parts. Those are some fibers are obtained from the plants, like from cottons, you will get some fibers. From the animals, like sheep and insects, we get the fibers. Like from the sheep, we are getting wool, and from the insect, silk worm, we are getting a silk. And from the mineral fiber, there are certain types of rocks with which we are getting those fibers. In these sections, I am going to discuss with you the advantages and disadvantages of the various fibers. Now, first I will show you the cotton. So, you show over here, this is a pure cotton duster. So, I hope you have seen this is a pure cotton duster which we are using. Now, this duster is made up of pure cotton. Now, right now I am just explaining about the advantages and disadvantages of the cotton. Today, cotton emerged the most important fiber and textile in the world. So, you know very well, cotton is emerged as a most important fiber and textile in the world. So, their advantages are as follows. Cotton can be easily cleaned. So, you can clean the cotton easily. You wash it, the cotton, with a normal detergent, and you can clean it easily. Cotton is durable since the fiber is strong. So cotton, any cotton dusters, cotton cloths, even made up of bed sheets as well as the pillow covers, they are very durable because those fibers are very strong. We feel comfort during summer by wearing the cotton dress. So during the hot summer days, we are advised or we are basically wearing the pure cotton dress. So we feel very much comfortable by wearing this cotton dresses. Cotton is a good conductor of heat. Obviously, it's a good conductor of the heat. Now comes about the disadvantages of the cotton. Now cotton is flammable. So cotton can be easily flammable. Damp cotton may affect by mildew. So if the cotton gets damp, if it is not washed properly, so it may be affected by the mildew. Cotton fabrics takes long time to dry rather than synthetic fibers. Now, especially you find during the monsoon season, if you wash any of your cotton linens or your cotton dress, it takes long time to dry because it is not getting the proper sunlight and it's not get dry easily for the same like the synthetic materials. Cotton turns to the yellow as limited just been exhibited put on the sunlight. So over here, after washing, if you put the cotton, any cotton linens or cotton dress in the scorching sun rays, they will turn yellow. Next comes about I am showing you the wool. So I hope you know, because this is obtained from the sheep or animal fibers. Now, advantages of the wool. Wool does not soil easily. So you know very well, so in a winter season, like cotton dress, every day you are not washing your woolen garments. So it does not soil easily once in a month. Or after the winter season, you can wash your woolen garments and you can store it. woolen the wear net. There are various types of color in a wool. So you can wear the varieties of sweaters with the varieties of color. So varieties of color are available in proper wools. Next, wool can be laundered and dry clean. So it can be laundered by a special detergent and it can be dry clean. And you will get extremely hot and comfort wearing the woolen clothes during your winter season. Next, we come about the silk. Now, this is over here. I am showing you a pure silk cloth over here. So, I can say silk is produced by silk worm, and they are spun from the cottons. So, the finest quality of the raw silk comes from the cotton of Bombay, you can say the Bombay moon. Is a type of silkworm. So you just underline that in your handout. The finest quality of raw silk comes from the cocoons of the Bombay moon of a type of silkworm. It's a type of silkworm, and from where the most expensive and the finest quality of silk is obtained. Now, advantages of the silk. Silk is the strongest of all natural fibers. So, it's the strongest of all natural fibers. Silk has a natural shrinkage resistance. It has a natural shrinkage resistance. That means it never makes scratches. It never shrink like the cotton cloths. Silk does not soil easily as the fiber is very smooth. So, silk is very smooth, very plain, and it does not shred. It does not soil or get dirty easily. Silk fiber become, you can say silk is having a very natural feel. That means you will also feel very comfortable by wearing the silk dresses, and very because it is very, very soft in nature. Now, disadvantages of the silk over here. Silk is weakened by sunlight. So, after washing, if you put the silk in a scorching sun rays, it will definitely damage the total linen. Silk is very expensive. So, like a cotton is not much more expensive, but silk is very expensive rather than cotton fibers. Silk becomes yellow with the age. So, as years after years, years after years, if you are using the same silk dress materials or same silk any linens, it will turn yellowish. And silk fibers become weaker when wet. So if you continuously just dip a silk fiber in the water, the silk fibers, they will becoming weak, and it will be easily torn. Next comes about the man-made fibers. Man-made fibers, you know, those are the artificial fibers. So advantages of the man-made fibers. So example of man-made fibers, I'd like to say Kerry cotton, Kerry linen. So advantage of man-made fiber, it washes and wears fabric. It can be easily washed, it can be laundered or dry cleaned easily. It can be easily laundered and dry cleaned. Synthetic fibers are good resistance of sunlight. That means synthetic fibers, they can, is a good resistance, they can resist the sunlight. So these are the advantages of that is a man-made fiber. Disadvantages, at a very high temperature, the fiber can bend. So, if you extreme temperature, so if you bring this man-made fiber very near to fire, it will definitely melt and it will catch fire. So, synthetic fibers are also low absorption. So, they are low in absorption power. So, in this unit, you have learned about the fibers, their classifications of the fiber, and their advantages and disadvantages. Thank you.